everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Asa and I make videos on home remedies, DIY tutorials and a lot of other fun stuff. So please like, subscribe and share my channel and keep on watching. And today's video is going to be about removing facial hair. I am a chimpanzee, so I have a lot of hair on my face. Not that people don't have hair on their face. I'm sure everybody has hair on their face, but it's just the amount of hair. And God has gifted me with a lot of hair on my face. So yeah, I've tried a lot of things and today I'm going to show you the bunch of things that I've tried and whether they have worked or whether they've not worked. So sort of a review of all those things. You know, another thing that I have a lot of is these. They're plural, not singular. I have a lot of acne as well. So yeah, and I have to go to Singapore tomorrow, which brings me to the fact I have to go to Singapore tomorrow. Yay! And I promise I'm gonna vlog this time. I shoot videos of all the trips that I go to, but I'm just not confident enough to vlog them. As in, I shoot it like a vlog, but it's just that I feel that it's not good enough and you guys won't like it, so I don't upload. But this time I promise it's gonna be good and I'm gonna vlog one, and then it's gonna be good two, and yeah, and I'm gonna upload it three. Please watch it. So the first one is waxing. Now, I've never waxed my face myself. I always go to a parlor and get my face waxed, and I really like how my face looks after getting waxed, because you know, waxing removes the first layer of your dead skin, so that's an added advantage. Plus, if you have tan on your face, it'll remove the tan a little bit, so that's a good thing about waxing. And it's same as how your legs and hands get waxed. So if you have like really sensitive skin and you feel like the waxing is not for you, then I think you should avoid this. I know a lot of people in India get their upper lip waxed, which is very, very convenient. Also, it's like the quickest process, because you know, they don't put it on all over your face once. They would do one side and once the other side and stuff, but it's relatively faster than all the other things. So yeah, thumbs up for waxing, and I would definitely do it again. I've done it only a couple of times because me being me, which is being very lazy, I don't go to the parlor that often. And that is because I've stayed in UK as a student, where I was almost broke all the time. So I couldn't afford going to a parlor. Parlors outside India are extremely expensive. So even here, I don't go to the parlor. I have other things at home that I use to, you know, remove my mustache and my hair from my forehead. I feel a little funny today. I don't know why. Maybe I'm excited about tomorrow, and that's why I'm like doing a lot of weird gestures. So please ignore them. Let's move to the next one. So the next one is an epilator, and this is a facial epilator by Braun. And it's a German brand and it's very famous. I think it's one of the best epilators you can get. And yeah, it comes with two heads. This is the exfoliation head and this is the epilation head. And you can see it's like really tiny, and so it's really convenient. Now it has two options. So you can it'll rotate in like clockwise and anti-clockwise motions. So that helps with removing hair from this side and this side, because the hair on this side is points towards this direction and the hair on this side points towards that direction. So you can do whichever direction is comfortable. I do my eyebrows also with this. I don't go very close to the eyebrows because I might, you know, chop off the whole of my eyebrow. And this brush is also very helpful for removing makeup. Oh my god, this is so good. So you just remove this thing and then put this thing on, and then yeah, you can just exfoliate the whole of your skin and then remove all your makeup. So I love this. Epilators are very, very convenient, and they are battery operated. So this is very convenient. If you get a rechargeable one that you can plug in and stuff for face, I'm not sure about that. But if you can find something, please leave in the comment box below for everyone else as well. And that is that'll be the perfect epilator, because you don't have to keep buying batteries and all of that. This is very, very helpful. This helped me throughout the first year of my marriage, when I was here and I didn't know which parlor to go to or what to do. So this is very helpful. It is a little bit expensive, but you know, if you're traveling abroad or living abroad or, you know, living in a hostel where you can't easily go to a parlor or whatever, you don't have access to somebody or, you know, who could remove your hair on your face or whatever, this is very, very handy. And I really liked it till the time I used it. Now, moving on to the third thing, which is probably the cheapest, but a little annoying and takes probably the most amount of time, is this small thing called plucker. And you know, I call it most annoying, but I've used this the most. I mean, I've used it for years and years. When I went to UK to do my master's, before that, what I did was I went to the parlor, I got my eyebrows and everything sorted. And then when I went there, I used to pluck 5 or 6 hair or whatever hair was there every day. And I managed to maintain the shape of my eyebrows for a year. So yeah, I used to do it every day. And this is still one of the most, and the method that I use the most. And what I do now is I use this mirror and I do this all the time. I always have a plucker in my travel case. It's a good long-term thing, because the thing that I'm gonna show you next is probably the least painful, or actually doesn't, it's not at all painful, but you have to do it again and again because it doesn't remove your hair, it just cuts it. And it is this small knife, or it's not a knife, don't freak out, it's a facial razor. And you use it exactly how guys use it, or you use it on your body. You just, you know, pull your skin taut, and then you just start taking. You put it like at 45 degree angle, and then you start removing your hair like this. I don't have hair right now, I think. Yeah, so my hair growth is this way, so I'm gonna just do it this way. And yeah, you don't cut yourself or anything with this. It's very simple. It's very easy to get the hang of. And yeah, I don't know if you can see, I have like tiny bits of hair that has come out and gone into my nose as well. Yeah, this is very, very handy. Again, this is something I definitely carry when I'm traveling. It is a little tricky to use near your eye, but if you keep your eye shut and you pull it down, and then yeah, you can do it. It's not rocket science. It's very, very easy. You can easily get the hang of it. Now, the biggest myth about shaving is that you get a stubble. And that is complete nonsense, because do I have a stubble? No. And I've been using this for like 4-5 months now. So I definitely think that if you guys are lazy like me and you don't want to, you know, go to a parlor, or you don't want to pluck your hair or use an epilator, then this is definitely easiest thing that you can do. You just need to wash your face, exfoliate your face, and then now I definitely recommend this to all of you. You guys should try it once, and you will get it on Flipkart. I've seen some on Flipkart and Amazon, so I don't know if it's available in stores in India, because I bought this in Malaysia. But then one of you commented below and wanted to know where this was available, and I checked on Indian websites. So it was there on Flipkart and Amazon. And yeah, so you can order off those two platforms and try this, guys. This is like, oh, this is the savior of all the lazy girls like me. But in the end, I have to say that if you're in India and you have the luxury of getting a cheap threading and upper lip done in a parlor, then obviously do that. And that, I think, is one of the best things about India, because you get to pamper yourself at a very reasonable price. So threading is definitely something that I would, that's like on top of my list. And then I would do this, because I'm lazy, then plucking. So if I have an important event to go to, or something that I do pluck, I mean, I'll pluck my hair, pluck the extra hair off, because then it stays for a long time. So if I have to go to a wedding and I have to stay there for like 3-4 days, then I pluck my hair, because this will give you those chotu red, black thing, no? the ends of the hair will show. So it's not that visible or anything, but yeah, I would prefer plucking if I have to go to an event on a regular basis or for emergencies. Is the best, because plucking also takes 1 hour. This will take like 5 minutes. So yeah, epilation after that, because my epilator is not working now. Maybe epilation and plucking would be the same, because it also gives you redness, huh? So you can't do it like right before, like, okay, now I have to go to an event, so what should I do? Let's pluck or let's do an epilator. You can't do that because your face will become red and it'll take some time, at least 15-20 minutes for the redness to go away. So yeah, plucking up and epilation after that. What else? Waxing after that, because waxing again takes you to the parlor. And yeah, that's it for today, guys. Please stay subscribed. Subscribe if you haven't, and if you plan to stay subscribed, if you have already subscribed, then please share it with your friends and make them subscribe. So yeah, until then, bye bye.